Hello everyone and welcome back to yet another lecture from Easy Dentistry. First of all, students, thank you all for your awesome response. Each of your comment means a lot to me. Thanks for watching our videos and subscribing to our channel. So here we are with another important topic in dental materials made very easy for you to understand, the lecture on impression materials used in dentistry. So the first question arising in your mind is, what is a dental impression? Now let me simplify this concept for you. If you see this flower, you admire this flower and your mind makes an impression of this flower. Then if you are asked to reproduce what you saw in this flower, you will describe it as a beautiful flower having yellow petals, green leaves, and it is very bushy, and it has a brown colored center or a black colored center. Now this is the way your mind makes impression of this flower. Now similarly, when a patient comes to your clinic and if he wants to go for complete dentures, he does not have any tooth in his mind and he wants dentures, you have a look on the patient's alveolar ridge. Then to fabricate the denture, you have to make an impression of this alveolar ridge. So an impression material is used to make an impression of this ridge. This is the impression which is made using the impression material, and this is called as the dental impression. Now when you obtain this dental impression, you pour this dental impression with gypsum products like dental stone, dental plaster, and you make cast. These are the cast of these patients. A cast is made, and on these gypsum cast the denture is fabricated. So this is the concept of dental impression. Now by definition, a dental impression is the negative record of tissues of mouth, and it is used to register or reproduce the form and relationship of teeth and surrounding tissues. So the impression which you make using an impression material is the negative record of that patient. And when you pour this impression with gypsum product and form the cast, this cast is called as the positive record of the patient, or the positive cast. The casts are positive while the dental impression is the negative record. I hope this concept is simplified and clear to all of you. Now let us see what are the desirable properties of a dental impression material. First, accuracy. When you make an impression of some tissues, there should be an accurate recording of those tissues. So accuracy is very important in dental impression materials. Then we use this material inside the patient's mouth. So the impression materials should have acceptable taste, odor, and color. The next important property is that as we use it inside the patient's mouth, it should be non-toxic and non-irritating. Fourth important property, it should have an adequate shelf life. What do you mean by shelf life? When you buy the impression material and store it in your clinic, it should have a good shelf life. That is, it should not deteriorate during its storage. Its storage time or the shelf life should be adequate. It should not get deteriorated or cannot be used within a short time. Then another important property, economical. It should not be very expensive, it should be economical. Then the impression material should be easy to use with minimum equipments required. Then the impression material should have adequate setting characteristics. When we place the impression material inside the patient's mouth, it should set within acceptable time. If the setting time is too long, it will cause discomfort to the patient if we keep the impression material for a long, long time. Then, when we mix this impression material, it should have an acceptable consistency and texture. Then, the strength of the impression material is also a very important criteria. When we choose an impression material, this impression material should have sufficient strength and it should not break when we try to remove the impression from the patient's mouth. That is, the elastic properties of this impression material should be acceptable so that the impression do not break when removed from the undercut areas. Then, another important desirable property of any impression material is that it should be stable under humidity and increased temperature. And most important property, it should be compatible with the gypsum products. When an impression is made, it is poured with any gypsum products. So the impression material should be compatible with the gypsum product. Now let us see the classification of the impression materials, a very important question asked frequently in exams. Now the impression materials are classified in various ways. First method is according to the use of the impression material in dentistry, whether it is used in edentulous patients or those patients which do not have any teeth, and whether it is used in dentulous patients, that is in patients which have teeth. Now, in edentulous patients, the impression materials which are used are impression plaster, impression compound and impression paste. Now, in edentulous patient, the requirement of the impression material is very different. The properties which are required of the impression material is really very different. Than from the dentulous mouth. Now, in dentulous mouth, alginate and rubber based impression materials are used. In dentulous mouth, numerous undercuts are present. Now, when we try to remove the impression from these undercuts, this impression should not break. So, for this requirement, alginate and rubber based impression are more desirable. While in edentulous mouth, the undercuts are low. So, impression plaster, impression compound or impression paste may be used in these cases. Now, the second method of classification of the impression materials are the mode of setting, how the impression material set. The impression material set by two methods. First, by the chemical method and second, by the physical method. Now, let us see one by one in detail. Those impression material which set by chemical reaction are also called as irreversible or thermoset impression materials. Irreversible because as the chemical reaction occurs while the setting, they cannot be reused again. And thermoset because as the setting takes place by chemical reaction, the change in temperature or the thermo, which means a change in temperature, do not bring about any changes in the setting of these impression materials. So, the impression materials which set by chemical reaction are divided as rigid and elastic. The rigid group consists of impression plaster and ZOE paste. While the elastic group, it comprises of the alginate and the polysulfide, polyether and the silicones. Now, those impression material which set by temperature change are called as reversible. Reversible because as the setting occurs by temperature change, the setting reaction can be reversed. And thermoplastic. Thermoplastic because a change in temperature causes change in the impression material. So it is called as thermoplastic. Now these impression materials are further divided as the rigid and elastic. The rigid group comprises of impression compound and waxes, while the elastic group comprises of the agar. Now the third way of classification of the impression materials is on the basis of its elasticity. They are classified as elastic and non-elastic. The non-elastic group are impression plaster, impression compound, zinc oxide eugenol paste and waxes, while the elastic group is further classified as hydrocolloid that are water-based and non-water-based or the non-aqueous group. The hydrocolloid group comprises of agar and alginate, while the non-aqueous group, they comprises of polysulfide, polyether, condensation silicones and the addition silicones. Now, in this lecture, we will be studying in detail about the impression compound. The other name of impression compound is modeling plastic. Now, according to the classifications we have seen, impression compound can be classified as non-elastic, reversible, that is it is set by physical change, and an impression compound, impression material which is used in edentulous patients. You have to remember each of these properties of the impression compound. Now, classification of the impression compound according to ADA specification number 3. Remember, ADA specification number 3 is for the impression compound, divides the impression compound into two types, type 1 and type 2. The type 1 is the impression compound which is used to make an impression of the ridges of the patient, while type 2 is the tray compound. As the name suggests, it is used to fabricate a tray for making impression. Now, one another concept we will explain here is what is tube impression. Tube impression is a single tooth impression. What is done in tube impression? A tube is formed. It is a copper band. This is a copper band, which is also called as a tube, copper tube. Inside this copper tube, the impression material is softened. The impression compound is softened and it is filled. Inside this copper band, the impression compound is filled. Now, this copper tube containing the impression compound is pressed over this tooth, and an impression is made. This impression compound, it flows into the cavity prepared in this tooth, and an impression of this tooth is made. This type of impression using the impression compound in a copper band is called as tube impression. Very important topic asked frequently in exams. Please remember. Now, what is the mode of supply of impression compound? Impression compound may be supplied in the form of sheets, in the form of sticks, in cones, or they may be available in cakes too. Now, what is the use of the impression compound? Impression compound first primarily is used to make the primary impression of edentulous patient. Then impression compound may also be used for border molding, for taking the final impression of the edentulous patient. Then it can be used for a single tooth impression or the tube impression. Then it can also be used to check undercuts while making dentures. What is the ideal requirement of an impression compound? Firstly, it should not be injurious to the patient. As we use it inside the oral cavity, it should not be injurious. Then it should be solidified a little above the room temperature. It should not be toxic to the patient. Then it should harden uniformly. If it does not harden uniformly, if it is soft at one side and it is hard at the other side, if we try to remove the impression with this ununiform hardening, the impression will distort and you have to take the impression again. So uniform hardening is desirable in any impression material and specifically impression compound. Now, it should record all the details with great accuracy. Now, the impression compound should also be cohesive. What do you mean by this? Cohesive means if you are taking the impression of a patient and after making the impression, if you feel that from one side the impression is not complete, then you should be able to stick some amount of the same impression compound to the existing impression and take the impression again. That is, it should be cohesive. It should stick to each other. Then the impression compound should not undergo permanent deformation when removing from the mouth of the patient. Then the dimensional stability is very important. Again, the impression compound should show a glossy surface on flaming. If we expose the impression compound on a flame, it should be appear glossy. Then it we should be able to trim the impression made by the impression compound with a knife so that it is correctable. So these are some of the requirements we need in impression compound. Now let us study a very important question asked: what is the composition of the impression compound? A mnemonic to remember this: Rose come to school by colorful car. Let us see the first letter of each of this word to remember the composition of impression compound. Rose come to school by colorful car. Rosin for rose, 30 parts is present in the impression compound. Come to school, copal rosin, come, 30 parts. To talc, which is the highest, 75 parts. Remember this, talc is present 75 parts. School, stearic acid, 5 parts. Colorful, coloring agents, that is it is available in traces. And car, carnauba wax, 10 parts. So rosin, copal rosin, talc, stearic acid, coloring agent and carnauba wax are the principal ingredients present in the impression compound. So rose come to school by colorful car is the mnemonic to remember the composition of the impression compound. Also, bee wax is added as plasticizer in the impression compound. This is a very important question which is asked frequently in Viva. The plasticizer principally used in impression compound is the bee wax, and sometimes shellac and gutta percha may also be used. Now we will talk about what are the fillers used in impression compound. Fillers are small inert particles that strengthen or change the physical properties of a material. Now, these fillers are chemically distinct from the principal ingredient. Suppose this is a dental material. The red dots are the principal ingredient of this dental material. And the green stars are the fillers. These are chemically inert and they strengthen or change the properties of this dental material. So, these are inert particles, different than the principal particles, and they change the physical properties of these dental material. Now in impression compound, the principal ingredient are the waxes and resins. The red dots are the principal ingredients, these are waxes, while the green stars are the fillers, and the fillers which is principally used in impression compound is talc, or soap or diatomaceous earth. These are the filler used in impression compound. Now, let us see what is fusion temperature. Very important concept if you want to manipulate or use the impression compound properly in your patient. Get thorough with this concept of fusion temperature. Now, first let us see what is glass transition temperature. Glass transition temperature is that temperature at which the material forms a rigid mass on cooling and it loses its hardness on heating. This is a particular temperature. From this temperature, if the temperature is reduced, then the material form a rigid mass, and from this temperature if heat is applied, then the material loses its hardness. So this transition temperature between the rigid mass and loss of hardness is called as glass transition temperature. And to remember, the impression compound has a glass transition temperature of 39 degrees Celsius. Now, what is fusion temperature? The fusion temperature is the temperature at which the crystalline fatty acids present in the impression compound, they solidify. The crystalline fatty acids solidify. This is that particular temperature. The fusion temperature of the impression compound is 43.5 degrees Celsius. Remember, very important concept. Now, what is the significance of this fusion temperature? Fusion temperature indicates a definite reduction in the plasticity during cooling. At fusion temperature, the fatty acids are liquid. So these liquid fatty acids, they provide lubrication to the dental material or the impression compound. And this lubrication in the impression compound helps to record fine details in the impression. Now, let's study the thermal properties. First, the conductivity and then the thermal contraction. The thermal conductivity of impression compound is very, very low. So, because of this low thermal conductivity, the impression compound has to be kept in hot water bath for long time so that this impression compound can be used and it can be softened. So this reduced thermal conductivity requires the impression compound to be kept in hot water for long time. Another problem which arises due to this low thermal conductivity is that because of the low thermal conductivity, the material present on the outer layer of the impression compound will be softened earlier, while the core of the material will still remain hard. So, while taking the impression out from the mouth of the patient, the outer layer of the impression may have been set, but the core may remain soft. So, under such condition, the distortion of the impression may occur due to low thermal conductivity. Now, the thermal contraction. When impression is removed from the patient's mouth, the linear contraction of the impression compound occurs, and this linear contraction is 0.3%. This linear contraction occurs due to temperature change from patient's mouth to the outside. Now, how to reduce this thermal contraction? First, by reflaming. Once you have obtained an impression of the patient in the impression tray, again heat that impression over a flame and make an impression again. This is called as reflaming. This reduces the thermal contraction. Again, another method to reduce this thermal contraction is the cold water spray. While making an impression using a metal tray, just before placing in mouth, the metal tray is sprayed with cold water. Cold water may be sprayed on the metal tray, and this reduces the thermal contraction. Now, what is the advantage of using this flaming and cold water spray? Stresses may be introduced into the impression, so it is very important to pour the cast within 1 hour to obtain a good quality acceptable cast. Now let us study a property which is called as flow. Flow is desirable as well as harmful. Increased flow before setting gives increased accuracy of the impression, but after the material has set, if there is flow, then there is distortion of the impression. Now, according to ADA specification number 3, the type 1 impression compound should have a flow of 6% at 37 degrees Celsius and 80 to 85% at 45 degrees Celsius. And type 2 impression compound should have a flow of 2% at 37 degrees Celsius and 70 to 85% at 45 degrees Celsius. Now, what is distortion? Now, if there is release of stress from the impression, there is distortion or destruction of the impression. Another important cause of distortion is improper cooling. If the impression is not cooled properly, there is distortion. What are the advantages of the impression compound? If we use the impression compound, it is very advantageous because, as it said, by physical change or a temperature change, it can be reused in the patient. It is cohesive, so it is can be correctable and also extended beyond the borders. But what are the disadvantages? It has high viscosity, so it does not flow into undercuts properly. Because of the high viscosity, we have to put pressure on the tissues, which causes improper recording of the tissues. And finally, distortion. Distortion is a very frequent mishap which occurs while taking an impression with impression compound. How to manipulate the impression compound? Two methods, if you want to manipulate it in small amount, and another method if you manipulate it in large amount. For small amount, the stick is held directly over the flame. But care should be taken not to boil or ignite the plasticizers used, because these plasticizers are very volatilizable. They will volatilize. And if you are using it in large amount, the cakes of impression compound are immersed in hot water bath and kneaded properly while taking an impression. So these are the two methods of manipulation of impression compound. What are the precautions which should be taken while using impression compound? Overheating of the impression compound should be avoided, because on overheating, the low molecular weight ingredients leach out of the impression compound. And over kneading should also be avoided, because the over kneading changes the flow of the impression compound. Now, disinfection of the impression compound: sodium hypochlorite, iodofo and phenolic glutaraldehyde are the three chemicals which are used for the disinfection of the impression compound. Now, here we complete with the topic of impression compound, the quiz time. The first question: impression compound set by what change, physical or chemical? Second question: impression compound is softened and carried in copper band pressed over tooth in which cavity is made is known as what impression? And last question: linear contraction of impression compound is how much percent? The next lecture will be on zinc oxide eugenol impression paste. Please subscribe, share and comment to our videos. That's all for now. Happy studying!